Hi guys, many of you guys ask me if I can do a review of my 2017 facelift Peugeot 308 GTI by Peugeot Sport after years of my ownership. To be exact, it's just over 3 years of ownership as my car was press model, so you could see it testing by car journalists on YouTube, car reviews, etc. So let's talk about design. If you're talking about design, I think Peugeot done a really good job. Second generation of 308, as it looks nice and sleek design hatchback, and GTI specification car looks much more aggressive and but not over the top, if you know what I mean. It have a nice sporty look, especially when you look at this two-tone color called Coupe Franche, which isn't standard if you don't buy it like that already from factory. This color is optional extra if you buy a car from new. So look at the front end, I think it looks quite aggressive. If you got Coupe Franche color option, the grille is already blacked out, and you've got nice red Peugeot lettering on top of the grille above that. I have bought French flag myself for the grille, just for a little refreshment of the grille, as it's all black, so it's like a nice little addition to it. Plus blacked out badge, which I'm doing myself with plastic. Didn't even take me long. I think I had it done in about 30 minutes altogether, and I put about three to five layers of color, and there you go. Badge also. I prefer it in black as it looks much more aggressive than standard chrome one. Another extra bits on the front end, as you can see, is sparkle toe strap, which isn't really functional, but to be honest, I don't really care as I put it there just for the visual effect. On the bottom, we have Maxton V1 splitter, which makes front end looks absolutely perfect, I think. It might be not everyone's taste, but each to their own, I suppose. And then your nice red bottom strip. On the side we have Maxton design side skirts, and some of the backs we have side splitters. All Maxton design, as I bought the whole kit to keep car the same level really, with all the bits of the car. We can't forget about two really nice big tailpipes, which is my favorite part of the car, as this little gap is just perfection, I think. Whole car is de-chromed, as it's two-tone color, so all window surroundings are black, de-chromed. The reason is, if you have a Coupe Franche model, facelift model, I think it would look stupid if you have chrome surroundings. Another thing is that if you opt out for Coupe Franche color, you can't have a panoramic roof, as it wouldn't look that good from the front or top, as panoramic roof on its own looks from the front or top and top like it's been wrapped or blacked out. So that's why you couldn't have Coupe Franche color option and panoramic roof in the same time together, like an optional extra. So you can have choose one or another. I bought my car like a press model, as I said, so there was Coupe Franche already. And then I think it will just ruin idea of Coupe Franche color, if you know what I mean, if you just have a panoramic roof and Coupe Franche color option, it just wouldn't work together. It will just ruin design of the car. Then we have factory tinted windows, apart from the front ones, as that's illegal anyway. GTI model comes with full LED headlights, which are absolutely brilliant. The only little minus is for me that there was an option for auto high beam, but I don't really drive very often at the night time besides city, but it's always nice to have it, I think. LED tailpipe, then we have LED tailpipe, taillights, LED reverse lights, which I changed myself, LED number plate lights, which I changed myself, LED under wing mirrors when you stop and open the car or when you unlock the car, as you can see. Mine are not a favorite thing for my GTI. I think my dynamic LED indicators, which looks absolutely brilliant and much better than stock ones, as they've been absolutely useless compared to these dynamic ones. But my other favorite thing on my GTI, my and these are actually so much brighter and definitely more practical than old ones. So let's move to the interior. So let's talk about interior. If you move into interior, I think it looks very unique, as when Peugeot came with the new design language in 2013 with second generation of 308, people being a bit skeptical and didn't know what to think about of the new Peugeot cockpit layout. But these days every car have big touch screens all over cars, so don't forget Peugeot started it all. Don't forget about it. It's a little bit shame that the infotainment system isn't the best. It can be a bit laggy sometimes and slow and a bit complicated to use with earlier models. But there is big but, that was for earlier models. With facelift model, there is an upgraded infotainment system which isn't that laggy at all, and it's so much easier to use. Thanks to TomTom built-in navigation, it's easy to use, and if you pay for subscription, you can have even speech cameras alerts. This feature can save you a lot of money, for sure. And I know something about it. Build quality overall is very good compared to the previous generation. Don't forget, this is GTI model, so it's definitely much better quality than lower spec models. We have a black ceiling, nice leather stitching across the doors, soft dashboard. Many people who tried 308 GTI had a problem with radio, multimedia system, control through central screen, including air condition. But let's be honest, it's not a problem for me at all, as I get used to it very quickly. So it's no issue for me here. New infotainment in my facelift model with TomTom SatNav, mirror link, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto. It's very easy to use for me, and I'm really happy with it. Optional extra Denona HiFi audio system is absolutely brilliant. It has a nice clear sound, deep basses, and there's no distortion or anything even on full volume. I fucking love it. Another optional extra is parking assistant, which I have too. Didn't really use it, only tried it once. It works well, but it's slow for my using, and I can park my car myself, so well, I don't really use it, to be honest. But for someone who isn't particularly good at parking, it's a great feature. People other concern might be controls on the handles on the steering wheel. For someone who is new in Peugeot interior, if you are familiar with Peugeot, you won't have a problem with that. And this is my third Peugeot, and I think it's very easy to use and intuitive same time. You can control radio, sources, speed limiter, cruise control, indicators and wipers through these handles on the steering wheel. Steering wheels on its own is a very big debate, as it's the smallest steering wheel in a production car. It feels amazing, and you will love it straight away, as I did. So easy to manipulate with, and my seating position is absolutely fine, so I can see the whole speedometer and everything. Of course, it all depends on your driving position. I'm sitting quite high, so no issue for me covering speed or something else, etc. The most important thing inside of the car are seats, as you spend most time in them, so you want to be comfy and maybe a sporty feeling at the same time. These are fabulous bucket seats, combination of Alcantara fabric and leather with nice special logo on top. Very comfy even on long journeys with massage seats, but to be honest, this massage seats function is pretty useless. But at least you can say you have a massage seat. Another funny thing is, or might be for someone, that revs are going all the way. To be honest, I didn't even notice as I get used to it straight away. So if someone tells you this is the problem, it's really not. No, maybe a little minus, maybe big minus, just depends. But for me, it is a little minus. There's no manual handbrake, which could be a great addition to the car, as this is light, hot hatch, manual. So manual handbrake could be really, really perfect in this car. I'm really missing that in my GTI. We have two modes, normal mode and sport mode. If you press sport mode, there will be change few things. So sound of the engine into speakers, which can be annoying for someone, but it's not an issue for me, and I think I like it. Exhaust sound is better and louder a bit. Steering is more stiff, and reaction to gas pedal are definitely better too. Visibility in the car is great, so I can't see any problem here. Practicality. We are in sport model GTI, so people don't really expect it to be brilliant or family car. These cars are people buying for fun and enjoy driving them, but it's not always only for this particular reason, as 308 GTI can be very practical and fun at the same time. It has a big 470 liter boot capacity, which is big enough for family, and it's got quite easy access. I'm only missing some side compartments from a previous first 308 generation, or if you want to call it MK1 T7. We got any hangers or anything like we had in previous generation. So I put that in here, as it's still better than you have stuff flying around your boot. It's nothing worse than shopping all over your boot. I hate it, and I bet everyone does. We don't have any spare tire in here, as most new cars. Plus, this is like hot hatch, so extra saved. Kilograms are always plus. I have installed K-brace in my boot, as you can see, to keep it even more solid on the road. And it's really helpful if you're driving on the limit. Two cup holders in the back, one in the front, but you need to fold it down to get access to it. I remember one time I borrowed my car, my GTI, to my friend, and he was complaining that he ain't got a cup holder in the front. But yes, I have, I said. You had to just fold it down first. Talking about leg room, I think it's not bad at all. It's not so bad. I'm sitting really close to the steering wheel, so it's plenty of space behind me. Anyway, I'm 1.75 meter. Average build and height, and people love sitting behind me, as I'm not a big person or tall person. The only minus of storage space in the car might be glove box. UK version have a glove box, quite small because of fuse box. Don't forget that you have some pockets on the back of the front seat, so car can be practical and family friendly even in this segment, I think. What I don't like in my GTI, that if you have a kids and if you wanna use a child lock on the doors, you have to set it first in the first place with blade key from your actual key fob on the side of the doors when you open them. So I know in as previous model have a simple button which you press, that's it, job done. Most important thing, and that's why I'm doing this video, is maintenance. Most people concerned about buying performance car or hot hatch might be a service cost and maintenance of the car. The good thing about 308 GTI is that it's not bad at all. If you consider it has massive 380mm front brake discs, which can cost some money. But don't forget, it's biggest brakes in a class. You won't find bigger brakes than on 308 GTI in a hot hatch. It have even bigger brakes than some supercars. That's why they're so costly. But braking performance of this thing is on another level. There's an issue with these brakes four-ball course. These Alcon brakes have pistons in calipers which aren't that great quality. To be honest, they are shite quality and will corrode after a few thousand miles, as all Alcon couldn't be bothered to put good quality pistons in calipers, so I have to spend 300 quid for stainless steel pistons from Godspeed Brakes, which comes in a kit with seals. I changed them after 25,000 miles, and thankfully I didn't have a problem anyway, as I changed them in time, so I prevented to have an issue with brakes, which can be very expensive. If you don't change these pistons for stainless steel ones from Godspeed Brakes, thanks Ben. So if you don't want to have sized discs and change expensive calipers, spend some money on these pistons and you will be absolutely fine. That could be my only issue with the car, I think. Could be, as I didn't have a problem with it, but I just wanted to prevent it, that problem. Over 3 years ownership, and I had zero issues whatsoever. Zero. Oil cost me around £45 for 5 litres. Filters around £30. Spark plugs about £50 to £60. So around £30-£40, I think, something like that. If you put it all together. I don't use cheap stuff, so I use all the best stuff for my car. I don't like cheap shit. Brake pads aren't that expensive. If you want a decent pad for good money, go for EBC yellow stuff. I only changed mine after 20k miles. Cost me around £15, and they are still pretty good. I think about 70% lived. I'm on 29k miles at the moment, and I still have standard discs from factory, so first set of discs. I'm not saying I'm a crazy driver, but I'm not steady either, so I like to push it quite often, to be honest. To be honest, I drive my car only for weekends and sometimes in a week, so after 3.5 years ownership, first set of discs isn't bad at all, I think. Depends on your driving style, of course. If you drive like a lunatic all the time, you will be changing disc after a while, I suppose. You can have a brake disc from dealership for around £900 or 895 from Godspeed Brakes. But after that you keep the bells, so you spend for your next discs only £500, so not bad at all, I think. Tires on the car from factory were Michelin Pilot Sport, which are really good tires, but not great in wet. I upgraded my tires after 2 years for Michelin Pilot Sport 4S, and this is upgraded version of Michelin Pilot Supersport, and I think these are absolutely phenomenal tires. Definitely best performance tires for summer. They have amazing grip, great handling abilities, and it's moving us to the next stage. Driving, that's probably I think most important thing why people buy this car. Thanks to the lightweight 205 kilos, powerful 1.6 liter turbocharged, 270 brake horsepower forged engine, which let me tell you, it's got some punch. All combined with 6-speed manual transmission, best combination for ultimate fun on the road. Car is pretty track ready with this whole setup from factory. You can go straight to the track and smash some much more higher performance cars. I have extra install aftermarket short shifter, which is definitely improvement to the original gear shifts, which been quite long and I didn't like it, so I put short shifter on. Now it's much more precise, and shorter gears are helpful, and if you need to throw gears faster, this is the thing where you need to get. So consider that if you want a better and faster gear shifts. I think it costs only £110, and I bought it about, I think, 2.5 years ago. Thanks to the small steering wheel, which I mentioned about, is your driving experience is even better. Especially on a B road where 308 GTI, excellent. And it feels like a fish in the water. Car can be sometimes a little bit jumpy or on uneven surface, but it's not so bad, to be honest. You can sort it out by buying extra HR sport lowering springs, 20 mil, because that's the only size you can get for freeway GTI. Or you can go for coilover sport. I don't think it's worth it because original suspension on freeway GTI is really good. So HR springs, 20 mil millimeters, they cost around £180, as I remember. So it's not a big deal really, so not so expensive. So if you want to go, if you don't like it how it drives from factory on the jumpy, well, on a bad road, you could go for these. And then you sort it. Not many people know about that freeway GTI has got strongest 1.6 liter 4-cylinder engine in the world in the production. Or best power to weight ratio, what is 225 brake horsepower per ton. More power per liter than Ferrari 488 or Porsche 911 Turbo S. Who love cars, we love this thing, as I think it's nothing better than light hot hatch with manual transmission. Love it. Economy on this car is not bad at all. I can achieve over 500 miles, 800 kilometers on a full tank if I'm steady on the gas, so around 40 miles per gallon plus, or if you're on a 6 to 6.5 to 6.7 liter for 100 kilometers, or 320 miles, or from 320 to 350 miles, 510 to 560 kilometers when I'm pushing it, so around 30 miles per gallon, and that's not bad at all for a high performance car. It's 270 brake, it's quite a lot of power for a little hot hatch. Car has got 53 liters tank, so it can be quite economical if it wants to be, or if you want to be steady on the pedal. And don't forget, my car is tuned, modified, so I think it's pretty decent fuel economy for what it is. Very important thing, reliability. As I mentioned before, I own car for over 3 years and I had zero issues whatsoever. It was press car as well, so I bet it was pushed hard by car journalists on the reviews, as you can see on my cars on YouTube and that. The only issues could be, but it wasn't, brake caliper pistons, which I changed in time, so no issue. It was more like prevention from my side, as I didn't want to see discs being seized. People are a bit skeptical and critics about French cars, but I have my third Peugeot and all are or been great so far. Our second car, Peugeot Freeway GT 2-litre diesel, is 13 years old car and is such a great runner. No issues, even with 120k on the clock. So people who are bad snobs should wake up, as it's 2021, not year 2000. New Peugeots are great cars and really stepped in the game, I think. If you look at new Peugeot 308, that was European Car of the Year in 2014. 3008 European Car of the Year 2017. New 208. European Car of the Year 2020, and I think Peugeot new design language is great, and we can see that is not the same Peugeot what it used to be. New 3008, 208, 508, 508 SW or Estate, 2008, they all are great looking cars. And now we have new 308 MK3, which looks absolutely gorgeous in my opinion. Era of hybrids and electric cars are coming, so we should be happy for what we drive really, as all fun and drama will disappear from cars soon, I think. My three-way GTI is quite rare anyway, as it's facelift model without GPF. With less weight in the new model, better sound and more power. So it's not always newer is better. We think for three-way GTI that it won't be new anymore, as last one was produced on 2nd of December. So sad, yeah, I know. But that's the reality, because of them stupid emissions and all that shit. So keep your GTIs and enjoy till you can. That's just my recommendation, because car is absolutely perfect and I had no issues whatsoever. Love it. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Be safe and see you in the next video.
Working on a weekend like usual, way off in the deep end.